Hello, this is Dave Scott Peters with TheRestaurantExpert.com, and we help independent restaurants with systems, and one of those major systems is putting together budgets. I know it's an ugly word, but all too often people ask me, hey, what do I need to get started with that ugly word called a budget? Well, I'm going to share that with you in about 2 seconds. Hello. This is Dave Scott Peters with TheRestaurantExpert.com. And budgets are critical to your business. They're critical. How do you know what success looks like if you don't have a plan for success? And that's what a budget is. And look, we don't create a budget and let it collect dust because we opened our restaurant 5 years ago and that's the last time you had a budget. Again, how do you know what success looks like? There's a phrase, a saying, that which we measure improves. We need measurements. So now, what we're going to do is we're going to take a look. What are the things I need? Number one, I need my sales. And when I write a budget, I want to make sure. Now, I'd love for it to be the beginning of the fiscal year, right? If I'm a January through December, January through December. But I'm not going to wait for a fiscal year. Let's say you're watching this video and it's July. Well, then I'm going to start August through July. Give me the next 12 months, a plan. So I grab my sales for my last 12 months, exactly what the restaurant did in gross sales, by category, overall, what did I do? From there, I'm going to grab my cost of goods sold numbers. I'm going to break that up by category. So it needs to be food, bottled beer, draft beer, wine, liquor, merchandise, all separated because they're all going to have different target cost of goods sold. My labor numbers, I need to break that up by position. I don't need front of house, back of house. I need to make sure I've got servers and bar backs and busters and bartenders and hosts, you get the idea, right? Cooks, prep cooks, dishwashers, not front of house, back of house. That's going to be critical. So I need those numbers by percent. If it's a fixed expense like a salaried manager, if it's variable, I need to know what the percentage is, what I spent last year. Then I break up my operating expenses. Is it a fixed or a variable expense? A fixed expense might be a manager's salary. Whether you do a dollar in sales or $100,000 in sales, you owe them their salary. But where I've got my hourly employees, they're a variable expense. If my sales go up, I use more labor. As sales go down, I use less labor. That's important to gather. Again, all from the last 12 months, your actual history. Then you've got to put together your projections. What do you think you're going to do in sales? Are sales going up? Are they going down? Right? That's what we've got to get to. Now, let me switch here. Here's what we're looking at is something called Budget Creator Software. Our members get this as a part of their membership. We developed this software, and I'll walk you through. Notice we have our sales for each month from last year. We've got our sales mix, right? What it was for each one of the months, if you will, or overall for the year. I've got my cost of goods sold, what we actually did last year. And I come down and I look at management salaries as fixed. I've got my hourly management at 3.5%, a variable. We do the same thing. We go all the way down to our expenses. We grab those. My building lease is $8,500 fixed. But as I scroll down and I find my repairs and maintenance, I run about 1% of sales, right? We do this. We build this month based on the actual history. Now, all I do is come all the way up here to the top. I'm going to right-click on the word July. I'm going to use this budget basis. I'm going to say yes. And magically, what's happening is the rest of the year is being filled out with the same data. This way, as I expand all, I'm already in a position to know what my profit and loss is. If I scroll all the way to the bottom, I'll not only have each month what my profit and loss is, but as I scroll to the right, I've got my summary. This restaurant will do about 9% profit. It'll have a prime cost of about 61.93%, and I'm shooting for 55 or under for anything. Any restaurant does $850,000 more in sales a year. But here's the big thing about a budget. Notice here my food cost is running 26%. I can put a plan into place, insert a comment here, and let's say I'm going to work on recipe costing cards. I'm going to have those done by the end of the month. And so in August, we're going to do a MPG, menu profit generator call, and we're going to re-engineer the menu to a 22% cost of goods sold. We're going to have that on the tables by September 1st. So I'm going to type in here and say new menu. And we're going to get this down to, what do we say here? 22%. So change this to 22%. I'm going to right click, use as budget basis from this point in time forward. Go forward. I'm going to come down to the bottom here. Now I've got to refresh my data. Look at this. We had a $133,000 in profits, 9% profitability. I'm going to hit refresh so the bottom numbers change. That little change was worth 2 points, worth a lot of money. I don't care about the points. Look at the money it means. So by putting together your budget, you create a plan. There's no magic pill. We snap our fingers and we're done. You create your plan. Look, if you'd like to have this tool and you want to take control of your business, give us a call toll free at 1-877-457-6278. Dial extension 106. Ask for Greg Sauerbach, our solutions coach, and he'll be happy to share with you how you can learn about our membership and how you can get your hands on this. This is David Scott Peters. Thanks for watching this video. Be sure and subscribe now to my YouTube channel. But before you go, download my free report. You'll find the link below in the description section. And be sure not to miss these other videos with expert tips to help you run your restaurant.